Do you want to use Google's ML Kit in your Jetpack Compose Android app? In this video, you will learn how. Hi guys, my name is Henrik Reis. I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. In one of my latest videos, I showed you how you can use CameraX with Jetpack Compose. At the end, we had a working camera preview and we're able to capture a photo. But that is not all what your camera can do. Google's ML Kit is optimized for mobile applications and allows us to process machine learning frameworks on our device. But don't worry, you don't have to train any models by yourself, but you can use some pre-built packages for various use cases directly in your Android app. In this video, we will follow up on my CameraX video with Jetpack Compose, and we will see how we can use the camera stream to directly analyze those images and look for text in the images and extract them to a local variable or something like that. If we take a look at the text recognition version 2 documentation, you can see that there are various supported languages, and it's also a thing that you can either use this framework and directly include it in your Android app, or additionally, you have also the option to download it from Google Play later on when you or the user installs the app. For showcasing, we will just stick to the bundled version. So whatever text you would like to recognize, just take the respective dependency here. In my case, I just want to use the Latin script. So I go to my app level build gradle file and include the respective dependency here. Once again, just like in the example for CameraX and Jetpack Compose, we have here a simple preview screen and it's wrapped in a box, and here is at the outside a scaffold. So we use here the box because at the bottom of the screen, we have a small text field that is automatically updated as soon as we recognize a new text. So if you haven't watched my video yet, make sure to check it out. However, I will give a quick wrap up of what this is about. So we use the Android view because Jetpack Compose at the time of this video doesn't natively support the CameraX library or any other view for CameraX. Using this composable, we can simply initialize here a preview view, which is a custom view for the legacy view system. And then we have some simple setup stuff here, which I will not talk about now. And the preview view is then at the end the thing we need to use. And we have a second function here that is called start text recognition. And here is actually where the setup happens. So we have here a camera controller, and we say here image analyzes target size 16:9. And additionally, here we set an image analyzer. And regardless of what ML Kit framework you use or model, however, you will always end up having a class which you can just input and the rest will be handled automatically. But hold back with your excitement for now, because we still have to implement this analyzer. But how you can do that, you will see in a second. So now the magic happens actually in this text recognition analyzer. And as you can see, our callback function here will finally return the detected text in form of a string. First, we need to implement the image analysis analyzer. And with this interface, we have to implement the analyze function. And as you can see, here we get a so-called image proxy. This analyze function will be called with the frame rate of the camera. However, as long as we don't close this image proxy, which you can see here below, no additionally function call will happen. So we can be relaxed and just analyze the image with the text recognizer, which comes from the library we just discussed. And as you can see, we just initialize it with text recognition, get client, text recognizer options, and use here just the default options. And you can see that I use here a scope launch. So we have a coroutine scope here, which I initialized. And why I do that is because if you don't add a throttle, so a small delay between those analyzations, you will end up having a huge overload of recognized text, because if you hold the camera at the text, you will probably analyze the same text for multiple times. So in this case, I use a timeout of 1000 milliseconds and that should be fine. But of course, if you have another use case, you could adapt it. Let's go through this code line by line. For the first line, we just extract here the image from the image proxy. And I just realized a small mistake here. We don't just return here, but we also, and we can do this by using here the run and say image proxy close, also close here the image proxy. So we free up all the resources to analyze the next image. In the next line, we then use the input image from media image, input our media image here, and use the rotation information from the image info to finally receive our input image here. Then we use the suspend coroutine to wrap the callback from the task, which returns from this process function here, and suspend it until it finishes. The text recognizer process is finally the part where we input the image we want to analyze, and then we can just call add-on success listener and receive a text object from the text recognition or recognizer library. And as you can see in the small description here, it does not only contain the recognized text, but also other elements like a text block and a text line and also a text element. But for this small example, we will stick to the text value here. And if it's not blank, so not empty, we will say undetected text updated and put in the detected text. Then finally, we just call continuation resume. So we jump out of this suspend coroutine here and have here our small throttle, which is once again the 1000 milliseconds. And then finally, when the coroutine completes, we will once again here call the image proxy.close. And regardless of what library you will use from the ML kit, it's always a similar process. So this is really the base, and then you have your respective recognizer, analyzer, or whatever, and will process just the input image. So quite simple, to be honest, but it always depends on a use case what you will finally do with the analyzed stuff you receive. But of course, I can tell you a lot of things and say, yeah, I'm using here text recognizer and so on, but let's look at a practical example. So this is finally the running app on my device here. And if I now hold text into the camera, you can see that it automatically detects subscribe to my channel. And what's funny, even if I go into the image here, you can see it also detects the brand here. So yeah, it seems to work. So as you saw, I didn't fool you. The package can really detect some text, and that is only one example of many which the ML kit provides you. So here you can see there are many other vision APIs. For example, the very popular one, of course, the barcode scanning. Then you have face detection, face mesh detection. Here is our example, the text recognition version 2. And then, of course, other stuff like image labeling, pose detection, and so on. So feel free to take a look at those frameworks, play around with them. As you saw, it's quite fun. Just to mention, there are also other APIs, not only the visual ones. So you have your translation, smart reply, and also entity extraction. So, but let's take a look at those in another video. Of course, you can once again, just like in the Jetpack Compose CameraX video, find a GitHub repository down in the description. And at the end, I just can say, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.